Welcome to the topic of the week 3, Advanced UI, ViewPager and Fragments. What is ViewPager? ViewPager is one of the most popular widgets available in Android libraries today. It is used in most of the famous applications like Angry Birds, Play Store, WhatsApp, and so on. ViewPager associated with paging. Paging is the act of moving from page to page. And on Android, you do this by swiping a finger across the screen. The current page then transitions in a direction and speed to match the finger movement. It is a useful and practical way to navigate around an application, but perhaps even more than this, it is an extremely satisfying visual effect for the final user. The ViewPager is a layout widget that lets you implement gesture navigation. In this short schema, you see that a screen contains Article 1 view. Then swipe will give you view for the Article 2, and so on. Using the view page requires knowledge of both fragments and adapters. In this case, fragments will be pages. So each screen that the view page allows the user to scroll to is a fragment. By using fragments instead of view here, we're given a much wider range of possibilities to show in each page. You can think of page adapters in the same way as you think of recycle view adapters. We just considered it last week. The adapter used here is conceptually similar to that used by recycle view. You supply an implementation of page adapter to generate the pages that the view pager display to the user. In this slide, you see ViewPager implementation in general. So, for example, we have three images or four images in terms of three names, just images of the same size and resolution. So we create, use, and give them these images to ViewPager when requested. And when we finish implementation, we get this ViewPager with the content of those three images that's supplied by page adapter. So for all this to work, we need an activity with the view pager on display as part of its main UI. It's usual activity, right? Application with view pager. A set of fragments to be used as page. A custom fragment page adapter that returns the correct fragment for each page number. So basically, adapter will be between your application, between your activity with view pager and data. And data eventually will be connected to screen layout XML. So let's consider ViewPager demo 1. It's introduction to ViewPager widget, no fragment used. So this lesson shows you how to do screen slides with the ViewPager using Kotlin, no fragment used. So we have two files here, activity main XML with ViewPager, pager item XML with the single page. Main activity and image page adapter. So first of all, we have layout XML main activity with pager. We have a simple pager item XML item for view pager relative layout with image view. And in main activity Kotlin, we override onCreate method. After set content view, we grab all the images and stuff them in our array. Then we get a reference to the view pager in the layout using findViewById. Then we initialize our adapter, page adapter. This class will be created soon and binds the adapter to the view pager directly. So what is image adapter? So this class basically inherited from page adapter. And the most important functions is getCount that returned the a size of the set of images. So set of images is basically array. The next function is view from object, connecting view and object. The next one instantiate item, that actually instantiate here inflate layout. Then this layout connected as a page item using inflator. Then you get a reference to the image view in page item layout. Set an image to image view, and finally add pager item layout as a current page to the view page. So please note the return image view, item view, I'm sorry, this is actually the view that inflator return in this method. And finally, we have a destroy item method implemented. So here, what a screen slide looks like, the transition from one screen to the next with different images. So please check image pager zip online. So the image pager, this is simple slideshow of this four images, nothing special. As I said, like we don't use fragment in this case, we just simply switch the images. So this is not very flexible method to use your pager. This is just an example. The next demo is UPager Demo 2, using fragments and UPager together in Kotlin. In this case, example will be in UPager Demo Zip online. So let's go step by step how to implement UPager with fragments. So first of all, we update main layout with UPager for the main activity. So basically, you see here constraint layout, and we drag and drop pager container here. So pager container has ID and matching parent with width and height. The second step is create a view for the fragment XML. Basically, this is a view for the single page, and we will be using relative layout in this case for the fragment, and we drag and drop here text view and image view. Orientation for this layout is vertical, and that's, you see something like this by default. So basically we are going to change text in this case when you scroll it. In the future, we also need to change image when you go from one page to another. So the next step is to create a fragment using factory method new instance. This is something new we didn't consider before. So why using factory method new instance to create a fragment? So why do you need a factory method but not a constructor for the fragment, which obviously will be maybe easier and more straightforward? First of all, because we did not define any constructors, the compiler automatically generates an empty default constructor that takes no arguments. This is all that you should have for fragment, no other constructors. Second, you probably know that Android may destroy and later recreate an activity and all its associated fragments when the application goes into the background. When the activity comes back, its fragment manager starts recreating fragments by using the empty default constructor. If it cannot find one, you get an exception. For this reason, it is the best practice to never specify any non-empty constructors. In fact, the easiest things to do is to specify none, as we did always here. But what if you need to pass information or data to a fragment? So this is the case when you need to use a factory method new instance. And normally this method generated by Android Studio when you create a new blank fragment. So we have to use this method to create a new instance of this fragment using provided parameters 1 and 2. In our case, it will be only one parameter. So the method return new instance of fragment, in this case, black fragment name. This is the best practice for Android for creating fragment and instantiate fragment using these two parameters. Then apply these parameters in a bundle in the form of arguments. So we create a bundle of this argument 1 and argument 2, and this arguments will be supplied with the instance of the fragment when we need them. For example, in our case, in the simple fragment when we create for this project, we create a fragment class that has only one parameter, so we have only one parameter and initially assigned to null. Then we use new instant method with one parameter and apply arguments using bundle and put in string as this parameter with argument parameter 1 constant as a key. So this key will be required for us when we would like to get string in the next slides. So when you want to update on a create view to set the text view, for instance, we need to get a string from the arguments, get the ID from the bundle. Before inflate the view at normal, we get the ID from the bundle. So we check if arguments has get string message ID as a key, and we save message in the local variable. Then we inflate the view, and then we get a reference for the text we would like to use and display the ID in the text view. In this case, this message will be saved in the text view by this reference. Please note, we could also handle any UI of any complexity in the usual way here, how we just usually normally works with fragment or activities. And don't forget that on create, you always return layout for the fragment that we just inflated here. The next step is main activity, create four fragments to be the content of our view pager. So what is here? We just make a list of three fragments. This looks like a four fragments. With parameter 1, 2, 3, 4, they all string here. And then actually this is when we call this new instance method, right? And we just put the string for this method to the bundle 1, 2, 3, 4. And then we have to supply adapter for the class. We name it simple fragment page adapter with the fragment manager and fragment list. So please note this class will be created soon, the next slides. And finally, we're using synthetic property access pager ID from the layout. Just assign page adapter to adapter. Kind of like a hooks up the pager adapter to the view pager. So what is inside fragment page adapter? So this is a class that extends fragment pager adapter and implement get item and get count method to supply instance of the screen slide page fragment as new pages. The page adapter also required that we implement get count, which returns amount of pages the adapter will create. So in this case will be get count return 4 in this example, right? And get item will be always supply instance of the fragment object in this case. So please check view pager demo zip online how this project implemented. So as a result, you will get the following, the set of fragments in view pager. So this lesson showed us how to put the whole fragment instances as pages in a view page adapter. To keep the code short and straightforward, we added an image and text view to each fragment layout, but just demonstrated that the pager is working with text only. So, however, it does not change the image. It should be individual work done later. So this is four pages like we have from 1 to 4. As I said, we do not change images here. This part will be your individual part later. And finally, ViewPager demo 3 fragments and tab layout using Kotlin. So please check ViewPager, the last ViewPager tutorial. So in this case, this lesson shows you how to do screen slides with ViewPager and tab layout using Kotlin. The difference in the main activity that we're using tab layout. So nothing new for the fragment home XML, just using text view in this case. But we have here a tab layout. Tab layout here go first, then we see here a view pager go the last match parent for the last of the for the rest of the XML layout. Here is what a screen slide looks like, the transition from one screen to another. So please check online view pager Kotlin tutorial master.zip. So in class activity, today we have to follow instructions and check all those demo 1, 2, 3, and run using your computer. And then finally, you have to complete individual part. So for individual part, you have to use the same Star Trek team. You remember we did it for the assignment one. So we should update your previous team project to use UPager as shown. So we will start from the first actor, and using swipe, we just switch into the next actor, and so on. So please note, all images should be the same size resolution, so the viewpager will look appropriate when you transition from one image to another. So please let me know if you have any questions. And once you're done, please don't forget to submit the project online, export to ZIP, and your personal reflections with screenshots. Thanks a lot.